This is going to be a pretty difficult job. It takes the full sheet, 24 by 36. It's going to be the outline and the words on a climbing pegboard for a gym. I'm going to start the machine and see how it goes. The first thing it's going to run is all the jobs that can be done with the V-groove bit. Some careful planning around those hold down clamps. It's cutting the chamfers for the pegboard holes. The holes will get cut out with a different bit. 18 holes in total. Just cut the last of the 18 peg holes. It's now going to go back and cut the the inspirational words in between each of the holes. Just finished cutting all the lettering. The next thing I'm going to do is change to an end mill and cut out all the holes and spacers and holes for the mounting bolts. Okay, I've changed the bits to a 1/4 inch down spiral end mill, and I'm going to start the machine, and this is going to finish the entire climbing pegboard. You see the lettering came out pretty well. The computer is checking the code to make sure it's compatible. It's going to cut all these holes out. It's going to cut recesses for washers, and it's going to cut some spacers for mounting it to the wall. That's a recess for a 3/8 inch lag bolt with a washer. Thank you. just finished cutting the 6 recesses for the mounting bolts. It's now going to finish cutting out the holes for the pegs for the climbing. Since it's using a down spiral bit, you don't get a lot of the sawdust flying over because it drives it down into the groove. All right, the machine is cutting the last of the 18 peg holes. Going to come down and finish drilling out the recesses for the bolt holes. The recess holds the washer, and in the middle it's going to make half-inch holes all the way through, including holes in the spacers, which is going to cut out in the scrap on the outside edge. The machine just finished cutting the last of 12 half-inch diameter through holes for the spacers and for the mounting bolts. I believe it's now going to come back and cut 3-inch diameter circles for the spacers for mounting the climbing pegboard to the wall. These circles are being cut in the scraps so we don't waste any extra wood. This is Russian birch plywood. It's fairly expensive. Just finished cutting the last of 6 spacers, and the final step, I believe, is going to be to cut out the complete section right along the chamfered V-groove that you see. The V-groove is going to get cut in half, so you'll just end up with a chamfer on the one edge. take a total of 7 passes around the outside to completely cut it out. So I'm going to pause the camera and pick it up again. This will be the final pass. It's almost done. There you have it, the climbing pegboard with all the words. Just needs a little paint, a backer piece, and it's ready to go on the wall. There you have it, the finished section of climbing pegboard, 36 inches tall, 24 inches wide, sanded, painted, ready to go. And there's actually a second piece I made, so as you can see here, it's double thick, 1.5 inches. These are the holes here for mounting it to the wall. These are the climbing holes for the pegs. Looks pretty good.